Welcome to Nynäshamn and to this year's Tio Mila. I have been at the arena coaching the youth runners in Ukomos, and now it's time to shift my focus to my own running for Riensbeko. I will be running the second leg tonight, and I'm looking forward to it a lot. Night orienteering at Tio Mila is one of my favorite things to do, and the second leg will be quite long, tough and demanding. But I'm really looking forward to this night. So now we just try to find Riensbeko's accommodation and rest and save my legs for the upcoming event. Then it's only about 1 hour left until my start. Jesper is out running the first leg right now, and it seems like he has done some mistakes in the beginning. But no matter what, I will just focus on my own race and try to do a really good technical performance. And here I'm listening to the first leg, and it's always really fun to get ready for a Tio Mila leg. So let's just do this, full focus on orienteering and doing a good race today. And that is how I want to run night orienteering. Jesper had a tough first leg, so I went out a bit behind the leading groups, about 15 minutes behind, but I really managed to do a good race all the way, and I managed to pick up 46 places. So I'm super happy with my race, and I really stick to my plan. Made the orienteering easy, tried to take easy and good night route choices, and the terrain was just amazing, so it was a true pleasure to just cruise through those amazing open hills, and it was a really nice experience. It's because of experiences like this that I put in a lot of time in training and or so in love with the sport of orienteering. Running night at Tio Mila is just a great experience, especially when you have the kind of flow that I had today. So it was really nice. Now I will just follow the race a bit from here and sleep before I will go up and watch the end of the race and see which team that will take the win this year. I slept some hours and now I'm heading to the arena again with Figge. We're quite tired, but we really want to see the finish. It's a really exciting relay now. It's standing between Ukkolinne and IFK Göteborg. And of course we're cheering for our friend Albin, right?
Yes, of course.
Yeah, he's catching up some time to Göteborg for his team Linné, so it'll be exciting. And for our team, it hasn't gone so good.
No.
We're around place number 60, which is not the level we want to be at. But now it will be really exciting to see the finish.
Indrets vägval jämför här med Daniel Hopman som kliver på rätt på över de här höjderna. Och här tappar han tydligt. Det är helt annorlunda än vad SK Kinnberg gjorde.
Then we're heading back to the accommodation after watching the finish, and once again IFK Göteborg was the strongest team this year. And I think I will end the video before I get too tired. And do you have anything to say, Figge?
No.
Okay, then we just end this video. Hope you liked it, and as always, thanks for watching, train hard, have fun, and I will see you in the next video.